Hello children, today we are going to talk about parallel lines, intersecting lines and angles made by a transversal. Let us start. Lines L and M intersect at point O. So let us take two lines, lines L and M. So let us say this is line L and this is line M. They intersect at point O. Such lines that have only one point in common are known as intersecting lines. That means now line L and M can be called intersecting lines because they intersect at only one point. For example, you can say this is also intersecting lines, okay, because there are two lines intersecting in one point. You can say these are also intersecting lines because they meet at only one point. So if they have one point in common and there are two lines intersecting, they are called intersecting lines. Now let us see what are parallel lines. Lines L and M do not intersect. That means there are two lines, lines L and M. They do not intersect. Even if extended indefinitely, that means suppose this is the line L and M. If you draw an arrow, what do you mean? That means you can extend. So even if I keep on extending, they do not meet at all. Such lines are called parallel lines. These lines do not have any point in common. Like the previous one, they had one intersection point, but you see here children, they do not have any point in common. Okay, so such lines are called parallel lines. And how do we write? We say line L is parallel to line M. But when you write it, instead of writing such a big thing is parallel to, we use a symbol, that is line L is parallel to line M. So what is this symbol denotes? This symbol denotes it is parallel to. Okay, now let us start with next topic, that is transversal. Now we will learn what is a transversal. A line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points. So we have already learned here they have told two or more lines. So let us take two or more lines. A line that intersects these two lines. So let us assume this is line L and this is line M. Okay. Now there is a line which is going to intersect these two lines at distinct points, means at different points. So let us assume this is that line N. Okay. So this is known as a transversal. Why? Because line N meets line L at A, line N meets line M and B. So A and B are distinct points. I repeat children, a line, that is this N line, that intersects two or more lines. So that intersects line L and M. Two or more lines means there may be one more line it can intersect. Let us assume that is O. So where is it intersecting? At C. So A, B and C are distinct points where this N cuts line L, M and O. So N is known as the transversal. Now for example, let us see. Now this is three lines. Okay. Suppose this is A, B and C. So what is the transversal, children? Yes, the transversal is line D. And where is it intersecting? At three distinct points. So now you understood what is a transversal? A line that intersects two or more lines. Now let us understand what is angles formed by them. What happens is when a transversal cuts two lines, lot of angles are formed. Let us see that. Angles made by a transversal. So what are the angles made by a transversal? So I will take line two lines M and N. They have given here two lines M and N are cut by transversal T. Cut means it is cutting it at T, and two distinct points A and B. So they are meeting at two distinct points A and B. What happens is 8 angles are formed. 4 angles at point A and 4 angles at point B. Let us see that. This will be angle 1. This will be angle 2. This will be angle 3. And this will be angle 4. So I can say at point A, 4 angles are formed. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3 and angle 4. At point B, again 4 angles are formed. Angle 5, angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8. So at point B, there are 4 more angles formed. Angle 5, angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8. So now, there are names for these angles. Now we will learn what are those. Now children, we studied that there are angles formed by a transversal, that means one line when it cuts two distinct lines, 8 angles are formed. So there are certain names for that angles. So we are going to learn that. Our first angle is interior angles. First angle is interior angles. Now the name itself suggests. Now interior means inside. What do you mean by in? In means inside. Now if you see this line M and N, between these two lines, what are the interior angles formed, children? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5. If you think this as a box, okay, think this as a box. So what is inside this box? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6. So you can say interior angles are angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. But now there are two types of interior angles. That is what we are going to study. Interior angles on same side of transversal, that they are also known as co-interior angles. Okay. Now what is interior angles on the same side of the transversal? Now this T is cutting line M and N into two equal half, not equal, into two half. So let us consider all these numbers to be left hand side and all these numbers as right hand side. L for left, R for right. Now in this interior angles on the same side, these are interior angles, just now we learned, because they are inside these two lines. So what is there inside on the left side, children? What angles are there on the left side? Angle 3 and angle 6. So you can say angle 3 and angle 6 are interior angles on the left hand side of the transversal or on the same side of the transversal. And angle 4 and angle 5, they are also interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is right side, angle 4 and angle 5. So they can be called as interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is right side, interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is left side. And one more thing is, if you add them, their angles are supplementary. That means if you add angle 3 plus angle 6, your answer will be 180. So when interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, they are also known as co-interior angles. So hope you understood, children, what are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. They are known as co-interior angles. Let us go to next interior angle, that is alternate interior angles. So we will study what are alternate interior angles. As the name suggests, interior, yes, they lie inside this box, that is 3, 4, 5, 6, but alternate, alternate means they form like this shape, a cross shape. So what are alternate interior angles? One is on the left hand side and one is on the right hand side. This is up and this is down. So you can remember like this, angle 3 and angle 5 are alternate interior angles. They form a crisscross. Now angle 4 and angle 6, one is right hand side, one is left hand side, one is on top, one is on bottom. They are also alternate interior angles. And what property they show? They are equal. That means if angle 3 is 60 degree, angle 5 also will be 60 degree. If angle 4 is 80 degree, angle 6 also will be 80 degree. So they are equal. Hope you understood, children. What is the first angle formed by a transversal? Interior angles. What? How many type of interior angles are there? Interior angles on the same side of the transversal and alternate interior angles. Alternate means they form like this sign. Okay, this is 3, this is 5, this is 4, this is 6, and they will be equal. But interior angles on the same side of the transversal, they will form supplementary 180 degree, and this also will form 180 degree. Hope you understood, children. Now we will learn what are exterior angles. So our next type of angle is exterior angle, children. Interior, that which lied between M and N. Exterior, that which do not lie between M and N. So exterior angles do not lie between M and N. So if they are not exterior angles, then what is left? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8. Because they lie above M. So this is a line M. See the angles, children. Angle 1 and angle 2 are lying above M. And 7 and 8 are lying below M. So they are not covered by any lines. And so they are called exterior angles. This box which is formed, these are interior. So what is left? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8. They are not inside a box. So they are exterior angles. Now, like interior angles, we have one more, alternate exterior angles. Alternate interior angles formed a crisscross sign, cross sign. In the same way, even alternate exterior angles form a criss sign, and they are exterior angles on the opposite sides of the transversal. So as you know, these are not exterior angles because they lie between M and N. So I'm just making them disappear. Now 1, 2, 7, 8 are exterior angles. So when they form a crisscross sign, this is left side and this is right side. So angle 2 and angle 8 are alternate exterior angles. What about 1 and 7, children? Yes, 1 is in the right side, 7 is in the left side, because this is all left, this is all right. So this transversal cuts into left and right. So 1 is on the right hand side and above, it is exterior. 7 is on the left hand side, it is, nothing is getting protected, it is also exterior. So angle 1 and angle 7, they are alternate exterior angles. And what is the property? They are also equal, like alternate interior angles. That means whatever is the measurement of angle 2, it will be 8. Angle 1, whatever is the measurement, the same will be for angle 7. So we have learned exterior angles and that alternate exterior angles are equal. We have one more to go, that is corresponding angles. Children, now we are going to learn the last angles, that is corresponding angles. So when lines M and N are cut by a transversal, interior angles are formed, exterior angles are formed and corresponding angles are formed. What are corresponding angles? The pair of angles that lie on same side of transversal and form a same pattern are called corresponding angles. That means they lie on the same side of transversal. What they want to say? That if one is in left, the other is also on the left. If one is on the right, its pair is also on the right. For example, now if you see here angle 1, children, I'm just drawing, you can see this line. Yeah, so which side is it lying? It is lying on the right hand side, and they form a same pattern and they are on the same side of transversal. That means with 1, corresponding angle for 1 is 5. Why? Because 1 lies above M, okay, and angle 5 also lies above N. So angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. They lie on same side of the transversal, that is right side, and form a same pattern. Let me see. See, this angle 1 is formed like this, right? See angle 5, children, this is also forming in the same way. So these are corresponding angles. Let us go to the next pair. Now 4, where is 4 lying? It is lying on the right hand side of the transversal and below line M. So the corresponding angle for 4 will be 8, because 8 is also lying on the right hand side of the transversal and below N. So both are forming the same pattern, right? Now let us see the pattern of 4. It is coming like this and going down. This is angle 4. In the same way, angle 8, it is coming like this and going down. Same pattern. What was the pattern for angle 4? Like this, coming down. For 8, like this, coming down. Below M, angle 4 is lying below M and angle 8 is lying below N. Right? Now let us go to the next. I'll show in this diagram because we already drew some lines on this. Now we have finished with right angle, right side. Now let us move to the left side of the transversal, children. Okay? Same pattern, same side. So now this 2 is lying above M, right? So what is lying above N and on the right and on the left side only? 2 is lying above M on the left side. So what is the other number which is lying above the line and on the left side? It is 6, and it is lying above N on the left hand side. So the corresponding angle for angle 2 is angle 6. Let us see its pattern. It's sleeping line and going up. Same way, sleeping line and going up. Now there is one more pair. Left hand side but below M. What is the number below M? It is 3. Left hand side, what is the number below N? It is 7. Let us see their pattern. They are both lying on the left hand side. Sleeping line coming down. I can show you in this also. Angle 3. Sleeping line coming down. Angle 3. Sleeping line coming down. Angle 3. Sleeping line coming down. Angle 7. Sleeping line coming down. Angle 7. So you saw, children, corresponding angles. They form the same pattern. They lie on the same side of the transversal. And one more thing is, they are also equal. They are also equal. So what did we learn, children, today? That when two parallel lines or any other lines are cut by a transversal, interior angles are formed, exterior angles are formed, and corresponding angles are formed, right? Interior, alternate interior angles are equal, alternate exterior angles are equal, corresponding angles are also equal, and co-interior angles, that is interior angles on the same side, form, if you add them, they are supplementary. So we will do many more sums on this in the following classes. Bye for now. If you like the video, press the like button. Bye children.